Hi everyone, welcome to Being Jewish, and today we'll talk about how to put on tefillin. So I'm a lefty, so I put tefillin on my right hand. But most of the world are righty, so I brought my son here, so he'll show you how to put the tefillin on his left hand. So the tefillin, inside there's four parshot, which have the important values of Judaism, and we tie them to our hand and our head, which symbolizes and affects our thoughts, that they should be clean and holy, and our actions, which should be righteous. So today I'll hold the camera and we'll zoom in on how to put on tefillin. So in a way, open that tefillin.
This is like a special case sold in Israel, which you can go to trips on, and they really protect your tefillin. So this is tefillin shel yad. That's the first thing you need to put on, the tefillin of your hand. So, first thing you do is you put the tefillin on your hand where the knot here should be near your heart. Okay? The place where you need to put the tefillin is on the muscle here. You know, just do that. You see there's the muscle where it's like a hill. So on the part here in the middle, you put the tefillin, then you pull it a bit, and now you say the bracha before you actually tie the whole thing to your hand. So, in a ve.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kishlanu mitzvotav vetzivanu laniach tefillin.
Amen. Now, you see you go outwards, and you get to your hand. And you need to put seven times. So this doesn't count. So this is one, two. Three. Four, five, six, seven. And then you like make a stop here. We'll get back to it later. Now you get to the tefillin shel rosh, tefillin of the head. Now you're not allowed to talk in between and not even contact people with facial expressions, nothing. After you finish the yad, you have to go straight to the head. Okay, now the head, you start putting this where your hair starts to grow. Even if you're bald, you need to remember where your hair started to grow. That's where you put the tefillin. Put it on. Okay. First of all, you start from putting it. You see you have this hole here in your head, right? That you can feel. So you put it there. You put the knot there. Put the tefillin on it. And you say the bracha.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher kishlanu mitzvotav vetzivanu al mitzvah tefillin.
Amen. First one was laniach. The second was al mitzvah tefillin. Then you have to take the tefillin to the place where your hair starts to grow. A bit difficult here to see. Okay, but it should never be on your forehead. Just from where your hair starts to grow, and then back to here, and it should be between your eyes. Ben enecha. Okay, and you should say right after you say al mitzvah tefillin, you say Baruch Shem Kvod Malchuto L'Olam Va'ed. After you put on the tefillin shel rosh, you say these psukim: Umichochmatcha el elyon ta'atzil alai, umibinatcha tevineni, uvechasdecha tagdil alai, uvigvuratcha tatzmit oivai vekamai, veshemen atov tarik al shiv'a kanei amnora, להשפיע טובך לבריותיך, פותח את ידיך ומסביע לכל חי רצון. Then you get back to your hand. ורסתיך לי.
ורסתיך לעולם.
ורסתיך לי לעולם.
ורסתיך לי בצדק ומשפט וחסד ורחמים.
ורסתיך לי בצדק ומשפט וחסד ורחמים.
ורסתיך לי באמונה וידעת את אדוני.
Okay. So you did these three go overs, and then finish it this way, and you have a shin, the letter shin. Okay? Right, and you have a yud, and you have a daled, okay, which, yeah, it's one of the names of God is symbolized here. So that's the whole thing. Now you'll see it again for lefties when I'll do it, but that's basically the thing. You put on yad, do all these, go back to the head, go back to the hand, and then usually what you say is Kriyat Shema. Usually you put tefillin on in the morning and say Kriyat Shema. That's like the most important thing, to say Kriyat Shema in it, and you pray Shacharit. But even if you're after the morning, any time at day except at night that you can put them on, any time at day you put them on, and you put them on every day except Shabbat and Chagim, and you see again that the knot is facing the heart. So now let's go back to tefillin of lefties. Okay, now we'll see anachat tefillin of a lefty. So the right hand is the hand where I'm going to put the tefillin. Take the tefillin shel yad, first of all. I won't be able to talk in between because you're not allowed to talk between yad and rosh, but you'll see how I do it. So here's the knot to the direction of the heart. Put it on the heel we have in our muscle. ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר קידשנו במצוותיו וציוונו להניח תפילין.
אמן.
ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר קידשנו במצוותיו וציוונו על מצוות תפילין.
אמן.
ברוך שם כבוד מלכותו לעולם ועד. After you put on the tefillin shel rosh, you say these psukim. U'michochmatcha el elyon ta'atzil alai, u'mibinatcha tevineni, u'vechasdecha tagdil alai, u'vigvuratcha tatzmit oivai ve'kamai, ve'shemen atov tarik al shiv'a kanei amnora, le'ashpi atuvcha livriyotecha, poteach et yadecha, u'masbi'a lechol chai ratzon. And now we'll go on. We'll get back to the tefillin shel yad to do this final tie. Okay. Ve'astich li le'olam, ve'astich li b'tzedek u'b'mishpat v'chesed v'rachamim, ve'astich li b'emunah v'yadat et Adonai. So that's it on anachat tefillin. I hope everything was understood. Any questions you have, send me at pevzystrudel@gmail.com, and being Jewish.